still S3 Riz. That's the ult hitting.
Yeah, ult is going to land. Black Shield comes down as Hybrid looking to go aggressive. Throws down the Killer Instinct, but he's gone the wrong direction. Beyond is going to easily pick that one up.
He was like to see the counter pick and nice play from MVP.
Yeah, we're going to see it one more time as well, as that is the very edge. And immediately just one Q and he gets rid of the shield.
A Q takes it down. The Comet and a W will take it down. That's the power of the Vel'Koz.
Kind of returns.
They didn't get the flash last time, but they're going for it.
If at first you don't succeed, send everyone top lane to try and get the work done. As ADD still holding onto the flash. And there's the Killer Instinct coming down. He gets into the pit. And all of the geometry once again on the side of Ever8 Winners is not going to land. Ian, can he get the Inspire Shield on top of him? I don't think so. As ADD lasts for a long time, but eventually falls.
Trivializing the CC immunity.
Well, in goes Kumai. He is going to get the bonk together as well. Kidnap is successful. Pilot in so much trouble, but the Disintegration Ray doing so much work.
Whoa.
Gets rid of the Kaiser, as now we've got the Call of the Forge God. Does get one as the bootback comes in. Really good use of the ultimate there from Beyond to keep himself alive, and the action continues. Knock up avoided with the flash there as Max almost managed to lock down the kill, but it's a 1-for-1 in the end. AD carries falling. No, 1-for-2 as Lucifer did fall in amongst all of that as well.
He's still trying to push in.
Yeah, Wupei's going to get the knock-up as ADD. Can he actually get out? No.
So he's just feeling like, well, I probably won't need the shield. I need the damage. And that's why he's gone for the Lucas.
Well, speaking of shields, Black Shield onto Kumaru. Does pull back Max. Gets knocked up with the Call of the Forge God. The ultimate comes in from ADD. Gets a good pop-up, but it's not quite enough. ADD does make it into the fight, though, as Kuma gets dropped down to the Bloblets. And now the Weaver's Wall to come in. Can we actually get any work done here? As no. Sun, maybe a little bit over-aggressive.
Near Pilot. Have less armor, less magic, just less health, and speaking of less health.
Yeah, that's going to be the catch. Beyond going to use the flash to get himself out. Stand United comes in, but he's not going to be enough. Shen
needed to have the entire hurricane. Just to see him on an off, his top
There's
lane.
The flash in, yes, Sun's in trouble, disintegrated.
In combat that lasts more than a second, you notice even there. Quickly well, taken away as we're seeing it engage.
Weaver's Wall comes in as well as the Call of the Forge God. Call of the Forge God going a little bit wide, but that's a fantastic flick back onto Pilot. Dangerous now for MVP as they're running out of damage. It's a double kill now for Ever8 Winners as Hybrid cleans up the last one now.
Yeah, with no passive, he can't rely on his smite finger. He's so squishy. They're trying again anyway.
Yep, Sun trying to do battle with Ian, but he's just so healthy. Wufei's going to make his way in as ADD is in trouble. Hybrid just Killer Instinct right on top of him. That's going to be the Shen falling, and Ever8 Winners. It looks dicey, it looks scary, but they're once again on the Baron as Kuma, Black Shield comes in and he gets sped up.
Ian could steal this over the wall, it's possible.
Yeah, Max could as well, he's got a lot of damage, but no, it's Hybrid that grabs it.
That's why they went for the extra pick. We'll watch through all the madness. The Weaver's Wall, the geometry, beautiful stuff, and Pilot knows this is not his day. No Captain Jack escapes in a fight like this. Really well engineered, multiple pronged with the Weaver's Wall. Beautiful from Ever8 to get the first.
Feels like they're a little bit over the hill when it comes to what this comp can do. Black Shield on top of the Zac, gets
double!
The ball, gets the double kidnap. The knockup's there right in the air as well as Max.
Everyone
He's an afterthought as he falls down. Good Subjugate comes in from Beyond to keep him alive. Takes down to about half health.
Trundle's not there yet.
The best way to win a smite battle is to
DPS
be
the
only
jungle.
Smite that's in there. And yeah, okay, Beyond not going to be able to get in for the horn. You know Wufei's ready to throw that one out. Hybrid going down relatively low. Some Honeyfruit will get him back up to health, though, as now MVP. They're going for the fight here down bottom side, but Sun, he's there. All of the CC is beautiful. The double kidnap. Now the Call of Forge God. Knockups are everywhere, and Ever8 Winners are destroying this fight. Hybrid tearing them all up. It's a double kill for the Taliyah, and they are super excited, wanting to take down game number one in this best of three.
Ever8 Winners trying to make it good when they need to. Couldn't even make it in the old system. Finished fifth. They already ran through the playoffs promotion. Now they're here in the promotion relegation tournament, and they're going to win game one.
Yep. Hybrid doing so much damage, and they're certainly going to win. It was an ace in the end. Ever8 Winners just, they've got a few minions, they've got a Baron buff, and now they've got a game one victory. And MVP, you mentioned the fact that Beyond shaved his head. They're terrified of being relegated out of the LCK, and now they're one game away from that being the reality.
Atlas, we could have our relegation match day, our losers match, be MVP versus Kongdu, both LCK teams. That has never happened in the history of the promotion tournament, but Ever 8 winners are turning it on in the business end of the season. They had no business really being here. They surprised everyone by beating second place Dumb One Gaming, by beating Team Battle Comics in the final, and now they looked comfortably better than MVP in game one. We knew about the stress on MVP beyond shaving his head. The stress is not going away. They're down 1-0, and it was a comfortable win for Everett.
Yeah, they just weathered the storm. I felt like the draft, as you mentioned earlier on, it made a whole lot of sense. The backline dive was good, but it was how they executed. It was Sun getting the seismic shoves in exactly the right positions, the layering of CC in these team fights. And we're going to have a look at it again. Just look at this. Almost all the buttons land from Everett winners.
And they only needed one button to win the team fight. Wait for it. There it is. Going golden. The stasis effect baited them forward, and then killer instinct follow-up with the black shoot. It looks like a set play. The quarterback lobs it in, and the ball in this case is Hybrid, who has six items, a damn on upgrade. The molten edge rips through MVP, and while Pilot can just laugh at the one person he takes down in the Morgana, it doesn't matter as Ever 8 wins.
Yeah.